The SVTV Filmmaker Interview Series is brought to you by Roche Winery and Tasting Room at 122 West Bain Street in Sonoma.
I'm Rick Love for the 2014 Sonoma International Film Festival Filmmaker Interview Series here on SVTV 27, conducting our interviews at Roche Winery Tasting Room on the Plaza. I'm very happy to have with me director-producer Martin Shore and producer Jerry Harrison of the film Take Me to the River, and this is celebrating the music of Memphis. Seems like a great time for music documentaries with 20 Feet from Stardom and Muscle Shoals and Sound City. Is this something that you were, it all came together at once for you with this film about Memphis, Take Me to the River?
Well, I mean, you're sort of speaking about the sort of a moment in the zeitgeist. Mm-hmm. And I think that there certainly is the idea is that if you don't, that people are beginning to pass away. And people are recognizing that if it's ever going to be done, it needs to be done now. Mm-hmm. And yeah. You know, and we certainly experienced people who, fortunately, many of them we did catch, but who passed away since beginning the film, and some that we didn't mm-hmm. do it in time.
One of the things I love about your film, as opposed to just focusing on one era, it's a continuum of largely R&B based music, mm-hmm. but you go all the way to hip hop, and you include hip hop as well, as opposed to just stopping with Bobby Blue Bland. Mm-hmm. Was that a conscious decision from the beginning to kind of go all the way through?
Well, the whole idea was to put together legacy musicians with stars of today, for a number of reasons. The value of passing things down from one generation to the next and accurately chronicling our culture is a very, very important thing, along with true mentorship. And so the idea of putting legacy musicians together with stars of today addressed both of those things, as well as having the ability to put genres together mm-hmm. and seamlessly. And when you're at the source of music, you can do that.
It's interesting that you talk about the mentorship, because the first time I saw The Clash in Boston, Massachusetts, Sam and Dave opened up for them. Mm-hmm. And it seemed like an odd fit at the first song. By the second, third song, everybody was completely into it. I mean, it was an amazing thing, because you wouldn't think these mm-hmm. genres would cross over, but it was all great, inspirational, uplifting music. And I think that's one of the things that comes through with your film as well.
I think one of the things that separates Take Me to the River from many of the other fine documentaries is that almost all the other ones are pointing out people who many people don't know were involved in the music. And we do that as well. But an awful lot of the most exciting footage in these other documentaries is old footage of old performances of, mm. and then people sitting around and talking about it. And sometimes there's a concert that's with these guys kind of coming back together again, which is usually not quite as exciting as what the old footage is. Mm. We have some old footage, but all of our film is focused on new recording sessions and new. You know, they're not songs that have just been written, but part of them are, mm-hmm. and the raps are, and things like that. So there's a freshness to it, and it's also one of the reasons that it's a film that you can watch over and over again, and you know, and you see something new in it and stuff like that. Whereas I think that many of the other ones, it's like, I'm really happy I know about that, but I think that at a certain point, and also a lot of the other films are a little bit depressing. So it's about. I certainly just watched Muscle Shoals, and you know, it certainly mm-hmm. had some depressing qualities.
Well, it's interesting you raise that, because my favorite Memphis band of all time is Big Star, and you could do on the power pop side with Tommy Hone and all mm-hmm. of those people. But you're right; it was a depressing story. It was a what could have been.
Sure.
Type of story. So, Jerry, your background, a big fan of the Modern Lovers from Boston, Massachusetts, and the Talking Heads, of course. Is this, for you coming into film from this side, so how did you get over onto this side of the...
Well, I had done a film with Kenny Wayne Shepherd that had been my idea about taking Double Trouble and Kenny Wayne, and us. We traveled around the South and played with some famous people like B.B. King, but also some people that almost everybody else didn't know about. Mm-hmm. It was called 10 Days Out Blues from the Backroads. And I had played some of that for Martin. And he goes, I mean, you guys just really captured a great sound. And so that kind of is what, that was at the, when we were certainly a lot less good friends as we are, have we become now. Mm-hmm. And so, and I was really excited to get involved with this. And, you know, it's also a great learning experience. It's like you start to learn the details. I mean, we were having dinner with William Bell after a screening we had here at Skywalker Ranch, and he's going, you know, Marvin Gaye used to call me up. And I'm going, Marvin Gaye used to call him up. You know, to ask me for advice, you know. So.
Well, it's, the thing that's great about it is you get to see, I mean, just seeing you, a very well-known musician in your own right, light up talking about William Bell, talking about Marvin Gaye, it's just, it's this continuum. But the well said about your film, it's about what's happening right now.
Yeah.
It is part of a continuum, but it's about what's happening right now as well. The film is Take Me to the River, director, producer Martin Shore, and producer Jerry Harrison. Thanks very much for coming out today and talking to us about this film in the Sonoma International Film Festival Filmmaker Interview Series here on SVTV 27.